Hello everyone, welcome to the iQuanta LRDF 50 series. In this series, we'll be solving a CAT level set every day till CAT on our CAT preparation iQuanta group on Facebook. Apart from that, you can post any query related to VARC, LRDI or quants on that group to get them solved for free. The link to join our Facebook group, it is in the description below. So let us start solving today's set. The question is, Cadbury India produces chocolates through 5 production units, U1, U2, U3, U4 and U5, where each production unit makes chocolates in 2 stages, manufacturing and packaging. The cost incurred to produce one chocolate in a particular unit for both the stages is given below. So if we read this table, we have been given all the units 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If we read the table for unit 1, the manufacturing cost in rupees of every chocolate is 12.5 rupees and the packaging cost, so here we have been given the number of layers that we need to package one chocolate in U1, it is 5 over here. Similarly, in U2, manufacturing cost of every chocolate is 9 rupees and to pack a chocolate, we need 8 layers in U2. In the similar manner, you can read the whole table. After that, every layer of packaging costs 50 paise and each chocolate costs rupees 20 to a buyer. So that means the selling price of every chocolate is 20 rupees because it is costing 20 rupees to a buyer. So that means it is the SP. And apart from that, every layer of packaging is costing 50 paise. So that means if we want to get a chocolate prepared from U1, we'll have to pay 12.5 rupees as the manufacturing cost first of all. And then since we require 5 layers of packaging, so cost of packaging will be 5 into every layer is costing 50 paise, that means 0.5 rupees. So 2.5 rupees will be the cost of packaging a particular chocolate, that means every chocolate in unit U1. So I hope you have properly understood everything so far. Let us solve the first question that we have. The question is, if there are only 1000 layers of packaging, then from which of the following units should Cadbury produce its chocolate to maximize the profit? So we'll check that particular unit in which we are maximizing the profit. So that means we need to take care all the units into consideration. Unit 1, then unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, and at last unit 5. Now since we have only 1000 layers of packaging, so what will be the number of chocolates that can be prepared by U1? We have total 1000 layers of packaging. Every chocolate requires 5 layers of packaging. So that means we'll have total 200 chocolates over here. Similarly in U2, again we have 1000 layers of packaging, so every chocolate requires 8 layers of packaging. So what will be the number of chocolates prepared over here? It will be 1000 by 8, which gives me 125. Similarly, you can calculate it for U3, U4 and U5. So in U3 we can prepare 1000 by 6, U4 1000 by 14, in U5 1000 by 7. This will be the number of chocolates prepared by all these units. Now since we are looking for the maximum profit, so that means we need to consider the SP and the CP, and we already know the SP for all the chocolates, whether he is buying from unit 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5, it is 20 rupees. It was given to us over here. So let me write it down over here. SP for every unit, it is 20 rupees. So now we have the SP with us for every chocolate. Now we must have the CP as well. CP definitely will be the sum of manufacturing cost as well as the packaging cost over here. So if we calculate it for U1 over here, in U1 every chocolate requires 12.5 rupees for manufacturing. There are 5 layers of packaging, so every layer requires 0.5 rupees. So here the total production cost, that means the CP, will be 15 rupees per chocolate. Similarly, in U2 we have 9 rupees of every chocolate for manufacturing. We have 8 layers of packaging, so 8 into 0.5, that means 13 rupees. So every chocolate in unit U2, it will cost 13 rupees. So similarly, you can calculate it for U3, U4, U5 over here. So CP of every chocolate in U1 was 15 rupees, here it was 13 rupees. You can calculate in the similar manner for U3, U4, U5. It will be 13.5 over here, 11 over here and 13.5 over here. Now since we have the SP and CP, we must talk about the profit per chocolate. So profit per chocolate In U1 it will be SP minus CP, so 20 minus 15 gives me 5. Here in U2, 20 minus 13 gives me 7. In U3, SP minus CP gives me 6.5, 9 in U4, and again 6.5 in U5. So now we have the profit per chocolate in all the units. Now, since we are talking about the profit, so let me calculate the total profit in all the units. So in unit U1, we could prepare total 200 chocolates. Every chocolate gives me 5 rupee profit. So 200 into 5 gives me 1000. Similarly, in U2, total profit will be 125 into 7, which gives me 875. Then in U3, 1000 by 6 into 6.5, it gives me roughly around 1079. You can calculate it. Similarly, in U4, 1000 by 14 into 9, it gives me 639 as the total profit. At last, for U5, the total profit will be 923. It will be the multiplication of 1000 by 7 into 6.5. So the question is, from which of the following units should Cadbury produce its chocolate to maximize the profit? So where do we have the maximum profit? We have it in U3 over here. So if there are only 1000 layers of packaging, we can generate maximum profit if we manufacture the chocolates from U3. So U3 will be the correct answer over here, option 3. Let us solve the next question now. The second question is, if the production capacity of any unit is not more than 30 chocolates. So we cannot produce more than 30 chocolates from any unit, and Cadbury needs 100 chocolates. So we need total 100 chocolates. What is the maximum possible profit percentage that Cadbury makes, given that only 90% of the chocolates could qualify to be sold? So out of these 100 chocolates, we can sell only 90% of the chocolates. That means just 90 chocolates can be sold. And ultimately, we have to find out the maximum profit percentage. So when can you maximize the profit? See, the SP of every chocolate is same for all the companies. It is 20 rupees, because every buyer is paying 20 rupees for every chocolate. So definitely, we can maximize our profit when we'll have the minimum CP. So we'll choose those companies in which the CP is minimum. We'll manufacture 30 chocolates from them. Then we'll go to that company in which we have the next higher CP. So first of all, we'll be manufacturing 30 chocolates from particular unit, then 30 chocolates, then we'll manufacture 30 chocolates, then 10 chocolates from the other unit. And first of all, we'll choose that particular unit in which we have the minimum CP, then just higher than that, then just higher than that, and then just higher. So let us find out the unit in which the CP is minimum. So we have calculated everything in the previous table. Let us have a look at it. So this is the table that we have. We have CPs over here. So we have the minimum CP for this U4 first, because it is 11. So that means we'll be manufacturing 30 chocolates from U4 first. After that, we'll be manufacturing chocolates from the company or the unit that has just higher CP than that. So it is U2 over here, which has next higher CP. So we'll be manufacturing 30 chocolates from U2. Then after that, the next higher CP is 13.5. So we can see that there are two units, U3 and U5, that have CP of 13.5. We know that we manufactured 30 chocolates from here, 30 from here. Now only 40 chocolates remain to be manufactured. So we can manufacture 30 chocolates from any of these units, U3 and U5. Let it be U3 first, then U5. So we'll be manufacturing 13 from here and 10 from here. Or we can say that we can simply manufacture these total 40 chocolates from any unit U3 or U5. So we'll take it into the second question, U4, U2, U3, U5. Now, since we can sell only 90% of the chocolate, that means we can sell only 90 chocolates. So what will be the total SP? Total SP will be 90 chocolates. Every chocolate gives me 20 rupees. So total SP will be 1800. Now, if I'm manufacturing 30 chocolates from U4 first, I'll be calculating the total CP of all those chocolates. So 30 into, from U4, the CP of every chocolate was 11 rupees. So here it will be 330, the total CP. Then the CP per chocolates in U2, we are manufacturing 30 chocolates from here. It was how much? 13 rupees. You can go back and check that label. So this will be 390 as a total CP. For U3, U5 total, it was 13.5, it was same, and we need 40 more chocolates. So 40 into 13.5, which gives me a sum of 540. 40. So if I calculate the total CPU over here, 330 plus 390 plus 540, it gives me 1260 as a total CPU. So we have total CP as 1260, we have total SP as 1800. So what will be the profit percentage? Profit will be SP minus CP, 1800 minus 1260 gives me 540 upon total CP, which is 1260 into 100. So this gives me 43% approx. So we can write 43% as the answer. 43, this is a theta question. Let's solve the next question now. The third question is, if Cadbury spent 1980 rupees on chocolate production, what maximum profit they'll make in rupees? So Cadbury spent total 1980, that means the total CP is 1980 rupees. Now we are talking about what is the maximum profit they'll make in rupees. Now since we know that we have the CP constant over here, and we also know that SP for every chocolate is 20 rupees. So how can we maximize the profit in rupees? If we increase the number of units over here. So how can we increase the number of units? We'll choose that particular unit in which the CP of a chocolate was minimum. So number of chocolates, it will be maximum when we'll choose that particular unit in which the CP is minimum. So number of chocolates will be maximum when we'll be using the minimum CP over here. So minimum CP, we could see in the first question that it was 11 for U4. So 1980 upon 11, it gives me 180. So maximum 180 chocolates can be manufactured. So if total 180 chocolates can be manufactured, so what will be their total SP? It will be 20 into 180, which gives me total SP of 3600. So total SP is 3600, total CP is 1980. What will be the profit in rupees? It will be SP minus CP, so 3600 minus 1980, which gives me 1620. So 1620 will be the maximum profit they can make in rupees. Let's solve the last question now. The last question is, if Cadbury can endure total manufacturing cost of 3600 rupees and total packaging cost of 1500, what's the maximum profit Cadbury can make if they use only one unit? So only one unit has to be chosen. And again, we have to talk about maximizing the profit. So how can we maximize the profit? So this question is quite similar to the first question. We know that a chocolate will only be complete when it goes both through manufacturing as well as packaging. So that means we'll have to take all the units into consideration first, U1, U2, U3, U4 and U5. We have only 3600 rupees to be invested into manufacturing. So let us find out the total number of chocolates that U1 can manufacture if it is given 3600 rupees for manufacturing. So it will be 3600 upon 12.5 rupees per chocolate. So this will be 288. Then if we talk about packaging in U1, we have total 1500 rupees to be invested. Every chocolate requires 5 layers of packaging and every layer costs 50 paise, that means 0.5 rupees. So when we calculate this, this is 1500 by 2.5, which gives me total 600. So total 600 chocolates can be packaged. So what will be the maximum number of chocolates that can go through both manufacturing and packaging? It will be 288 only. Similarly for U2, we have 3600 for manufacturing. Every chocolate requires 9 rupees. So we can manufacture total 400 chocolates over here. If we talk about packaging, 1500 rupees for packaging. Every chocolate requires 8 layers of packaging and every layer costs 0.5 rupees. So this is 1500 by 4, which gives me 375. So total how many chocolates can go through both packaging and manufacturing? It will be 375 over here. Similarly, you can calculate it for U3, U4, U5 as well. So I have calculated the maximum number of chocolates that can go through both manufacturing and packaging for every unit. Now we have to talk about the maximum profit over here. So that means we'll have to use the profit per chocolate in U1, U2, U3, U4, U5. And if we go back to the table that we first draw over here, we can see that in U1 profit per chocolate is 5 rupees, 7 rupees in U2, 6.5 in U3. So we'll write this into the table that we have formed. So this is the profit per chocolate. Now what we'll calculate, we'll calculate the total profit in every unit. So 288 into 5, because 288 units can be made over here. Every chocolate gives 5 rupee profit. So total profit here will be 1440. Here it will be 2625. 342 into 6.5. It gives me something around 2223. This gives me 1926 upon calculating, and this gives me something around 2340. So where do we have the maximum profit? We have it over here for U2 2625. So this will be the maximum profit, 2625, and we will generate it when we employ this money, 3600 of manufacturing into U2 and this total packaging cost of 1500 into U2. So this is the company that will give us the maximum profit in this case, and that will be 2625 rupees. So that's all with this set. This wasn't very tough. I hope the explanation is clear to you. If not, please make a comment. If you want regular notifications regarding the video solutions for LRDI sets, you can subscribe the iQuanta channel. We'll come up with another set and another video solution tomorrow. Thank you.